These are two new lenses that you should consider for your upcoming cataract surgery. Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist and cataract surgeon. Last month, I attended the American Society of Cataract and Refractive Surgery, and while I was there, I got to learn about some exciting new technology, including two new lenses that are coming out or have come out this year. In this video, let's talk about these lenses and what you need to know. A cataract is a clouding of the natural lens that's inside your eye, and we're all going to develop a cataract over time. The only definitive treatment for cataracts is cataract surgery. During surgery, we take out the cloudy parts of your natural lens and put in a brand new synthetic lens. While the primary goal of cataract surgery is to improve your vision with glasses or contact lenses, some people will use this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to pick out a lens that will allow them to become spectacle independent for some or all activities. The cost of the surgery includes a standard lens, which is a lens that is the same power throughout. This lens does not correct astigmatism, nor does it provide a range of vision. The majority of eyes that have the standard lens inserted during the surgery will require glasses either part-time or full-time after surgery. For those who are looking for a glasses-free lifestyle, there are two strategies to make this happen. One strategy is called monovision. This is when you set your dominant eye for distance and you offset the non-dominant eye either to somewhere in the intermediate or near range. This option is not for everybody, as some people have a very hard time tolerating monovision, especially if they have not done this before. Another strategy is to use a category of lenses called presbyopia correcting lenses. These are lenses that can provide a range of vision, and the most popular option is a lens called a multifocal lens, which focuses light at multiple focal points. The downside for most multifocal lenses is a loss of contrast, glare or halos at nighttime, and compromised intermediate and near vision. So as you can see, we don't have a way to get your 20-year-old eyes back, but we do have these two new lenses that get you a little bit closer. This first lens that I'm excited to share with you is a version of the light adjustable lens called the LAL Plus. The original light adjustable lens, otherwise known as LAL, is the first lens that can be put inside the eye and then adjusted after cataract surgery. The LAL is my current favorite premium lens to offer patients, as you cannot really beat the precision and flexibility. The only downside to the traditional LAL is that we can't really promise any sort of extended depth of focus. Most patients will either pick two eyes to focus at the same focal point or offset the two eyes a little bit, but we'll still need to wear glasses for something. And we can't really promise that you'll be completely glasses free. After the light adjustable lens is placed in the eye during cataract surgery, after an appropriate healing period, the lens is adjusted using a light treatment to change the power of the lens. I really love offering this lens to patients who have had refractive surgery such as LASIK, PRK or RK, as well as anyone who has any kind of corneal disease or has had a history of cornea surgery. I also love offering this lens to those who are particular about their visual outcomes after surgery, and you perfectionists out there who want that near perfect outcome. This is also a great way to try out monovision or some version of monovision without getting stuck if you don't like the results. The newest version of the light adjustable lens, the LAL Plus, is just like the original LAL, but with the additional benefit of some extended depth of focus. This means that instead of one focal point, this lens can offer a small extended range. This is due to a small amount of continuous increase in the central lens power. This is great for those who want to do something called mini monovision, where we set one eye for distance and put the other eye for about intermediate vision. The distance eye will have some range between distance and intermediate, and that intermediate eye will have some range of intermediate to far near. You might still need to wear reading glasses for very small print. This combination should get you closer to spectacle independence. Both the LAL and the LAL Plus are contraindicated if you are taking medications that increase your sensitivity to UV, medications that are toxic to your retina, if you've had a history of herpes infection inside the eye, if you have nystagmus or shaky eyes, or if you are unable to wear UV protecting glasses when you're outside. I'm starting to offer these LAL Plus lenses in my own practice, and in a future video, I'm excited to share with you my thoughts. The next lens I'm excited to share with you is the Odyssey lens by Johnson & Johnson. This is a multifocal lens, which incorporates a proprietary technology to provide a range of vision from distance to intermediate to near. The Odyssey is a trifocal lens, which means that the primary focal point is at distance, but there is a focal point for intermediate vision and near vision as well. My current go-to multifocal lens is the Synergy lens, also by Johnson & Johnson. I like offering the Synergy lens to my patient due to the superior near vision it can offer. However, there is no such thing as a perfect lens, and the Synergy does have some downsides. For example, while the near vision for the Synergy lens is excellent, the overemphasis of near vision sometimes comes at the cost of having very clear distance vision. The Odyssey multifocal lens was designed to correct some of the downsides of the Synergy multifocal lens by providing both clear distance and clear near vision. This lens also promises reduced nighttime glare, improved contrast, and improved low light performance compared to other multifocal lenses. This lens will be fully released by the summer of 2024. As I implant more and more of these lenses, I plan to make a review video talking about my experiences and my thoughts on these lenses. So be sure to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.